Hey everybody, it's Invictus. Time for another solo queue silliness here on the channel. Today, we're going to be playing as Zarafool, which was a popular request from some of the members of the Mosh Pit here on YouTube. On our team today, we've got Falstad, Abathur, Zarafool, Nazebro, and Vala. Taking on a new brack, Nazebro, the Butcher, Zeratul, and Nova. Must be a Zeratul Nova weekend, I'm not sure. We've got double stealthy versus single stealthy, and this is all going to be kinds of crazy hilarious. I'm expecting a lot of really, really fast kills in this game. I'm saying that the over-under for total kills in this game is going to be, let's say 35 or over. I'm going to go take the over on that. I think there's going to be more than 35 total kills between the two teams. Level 1, I'm going to go for Regeneration Master. This is a little bit of a different build that I've shown on a on Solo Queue Silliness before on Zeratul. And I know a couple people have been kind of disappointed with the lack of, oh, let's just call it quality, as far as the last couple of games that have been recently put out here on the channel. And all I can say is I don't really have any control over that. I mean, we get what we get as far as teams are concerned. And Lord knows if I could get a winning team all day, every day, I would take it easily. But the fact of the matter is, I am at the mercy of four other people. So if I can't carry from support, especially on support, and you know, I try not to make too many excuses whenever it comes down to actually losing or winning in Heroes of the Storm. It's very, very easy to pick out like where your shortcomings are as far as a team or who'd missed what or that sort of thing, yada yada. But at the end of the day, You really can't say too much about losing if you do end up losing. I'm gonna go after the Butcher here and get the heck on out of dodge. I do see that Zarafool is right there. I would love to get this next regen globe if I can. Here we go. I'm not doing that to fight their Falstad. Although I'm not sure exactly what the Butcher's thinking here. I should be able to get a kill there. Yeah, I am able to get it. Abathur gonna save me. Save me, Abathur. Whoa! He blinked into the. Why would you do that? He blinked into double turret fire. Well, thank you, Abathur. That would have helped. I think that was definitely worth it. I mean, we got 2 for 2 there, but we ended up killing Zeratul. What's the other Zeratul doing? He's going for Regeneration Master 2. Fancy that. But yeah, so anyway, going back to the whole, you know, winning games, I don't revel in the idea of posting losing games as much as I mean, obviously I don't want to lose, but at the same time, again, like I said, there's not really much I can do as far as if we lose a bunch of games in a row. What do you want me to do? You know, it's like, I really would love to get better, but at the end of the day, especially if I'm playing support, I can't really carry as much as often. I still have that support daily, by the way, but I know that a lot of people were asking for a little bit of a change up, and I totally get how, not boring, but how tedious watching support can be, especially as it is not really a glamorous affair from that particular role. So totally get that, and I just appreciate the support, everyone here on YouTube. Here comes the Butcherino. He's going to charge right on in, and Vala's going to get Nova'd at the same time. There's no way I'm going to get out of here. That's a 4-man gank, and I'm just not even going to worry about it right now, man. I was literally a 4-man gank. It was Nova, Zeratul, Anubarak, and the Butcher all at the same time on Vala, which was pretty funny, I gotta say. Not really gonna do too much of anything right now. I'm just making sure that I'm clearing the wave, getting XP, etc., etc. Nazebro and Falstad are down below. Looks like, it does look like Vala is on the way. I did see Nova in the brush. Falstad actually did die. Nova missed the snipe on me. Actually missed the singularity spike. Nice job with the zombie wall there from Nazebro. We should be able to pick up the kill on the Butcher. I'm honestly surprised that the Butcher did not, or not the Butcher, but I'm honestly surprised that nobody actually tried to go for Vala there. Falstad has finally come up here. He didn't stop the tribute, but we were able to get a couple kills, and that's fine. So very, very good team fight overall. I mean, we did kind of screw the pooch a little bit there. We could have probably stopped them, but I was more concerned about where Nova was, because after I came out and killed Zeratul, I was really, really worried about getting just one shot sniped there by Nova. So let's see if we can get a little bit of damage here on the Zeratul Duncan stand. I was able to land the Singularity Spike. Unfortunately, though, I was not able to land the Killing Blow. We could get the Regen Globe, would be nice. Nope, just kidding. Glory to the firstborn. So let's see if we can spot anyone down here. It's usually not a good idea, and I this is kind of an amateur. I don't want to say pro tip. This is an amateur tip. If you are playing on a stealth hero, you want to try to limit the amount of movement, especially if you're on a mount. And I'm doing the complete opposite of that right now. The reason why I say that is because it's much easier for the enemy team to see where your sheen is, where the stealth animation is, if you're moving around a lot. Next tribute is gonna be spawning down here in the mid lane, and Nazebo calling the Butcher MIA. Always love seeing that sort of communication across our teammates. Fortunately, Vala did get killed by Zeratul and Nubarak. And down goes Falstad as well, so there's not going to be much that Nazebo, Abathur, and I are going to be able to do to stop this tribute, and I think we're just better off just letting it go. Zeratul tried to Zeratul me, and Zeratul me once, shame on me. Zeratul me twice, we're all going to have three, I don't know. This Zeratul, man, he didn't learn his lesson last time that he actually blunk into a two turret raid here in the mid lane. I'm gonna let him do it. He's getting a little too bold for his britches here. Actually missed the Singularity Spike, but Vala almost got insta-gibbed by Zeratul and Nova. So good job on Vala for at least not dying there. It's a delicate balance when you're playing a stealth hero because you have to move to make sure you don't get skill shotted by Nova, but at the same time, you don't want to move too much because you don't want to give away your position. I saw Zeratul coming in from the side. All I'm doing is basically prioritizing making sure that we're getting those regen globes for the Regeneration Master talent. And that goes along the same lines of the good old Seasoned Marksman benchmark that I did a while ago, which is you want to be twice the amount of stacks of time that has elapsed. Right now, I should be at 12 stacks. I'm only at 10, but that's because we did have a little bit of a snafu early on. There, I did go for Void Prison, and this time around, both teams do have their heroics. So, Void Prison is what I'm going to go. Let's see what the other Zeratul went. He did go also Void Prison as well. Whoa, Zeratul, where are you going? Wrong way there, rerun. Falstad and Abathur should get on top of that. Or not. Not sure why Falstad is deciding to not go for this. I did throw out the Void Prison. I was able to catch the real Nova in there along with the Nubarak. Gonna go after the Butcher, who actually charged about 30 miles away. So down goes the Butcher. The enemy team's probably going to end up getting the tribute here, but we were able to get two kills. There's the tribute. And honestly, it's not that big of a deal to give up the first tribute cycle. I mean, it's not good, don't get me wrong. It's certainly not... It's not what I would say is, let's say efficient or desired, but it's not the end of the world. It's only the first tribute cycle. We can come back from that, I don't want to say easily, but it's definitely possible. I don't know why we didn't get the, we should have gotten that regen globe there. I don't know about that one, Blizzard. And we need to see if the enemy team's actually doing their boss camp right now. I don't think they would, but you never know. The Butcher's down in the bot lane. There's a new brack. Yeah, there's no way that they're going to be doing their boss camp right now. If we can take down the Butcher, that'd be a big piece of firepower we can take off the map. Okay, I want to make sure that I do not give the Butcher any sort of advantage there with the Butcher's brand. I spent a little bit too long there fighting with the Butcher's brand on me, unfortunately. But I am going to go back and get a little bit of a top off. Vala is still having issues with Nazeba, or with Zeratul and Nova. But overall, that tribute cycle really did not cost us anything. We lost the turrets in the mid, and that's about it. Not that big of a deal, like I said. And at the end of the day, we're actually up on levels right now, so we're doing okay. Zeratul is down in the bottom. Nova is at the top. There we go. And I'm basically just going to be soaking here in mid and waiting to see who comes around here. There's Zeratul. See, what is Abathur going for? He did go for Adrenal Overload. That's good. Definitely like that a lot. Level 13, I am going to be going for good old-fashioned Giant Killer. There's pretty much no reason not to ever to not take to take Giant Killer. I mean, the only talent that I would say level 13 is decent for Zeratul other than Giant Killer would be Wormhole. But honestly, Wormhole is kind of unwieldy, and I'm not saying that it's too hard to use. It's just it can be awkward. And using Wormhole isn't exactly all that great for assassinations. I do see Zeratul right here in front of me, actually. I'm not sure where that blink went, though. Whoa, Butcher coming all the way over here. I'd like to see you try, Butcher. Of course, that Mighty Gust did end up killing me, so I appreciate that, Falstad. But at least we were able to get two. I mean, I actually got three, so I'm okay with that. Even two for one, I'm okay with that. Yeah, I didn't have to turn around and take out the Butcher, because I probably could have blunked this way, but I wanted to make sure we at least got one kill, so it's okay. So right now, 10-10, very, very even matchup right now. Level 14. We should have an easy-peasy time getting this tribute. There should be no doubt about it. I'm going to go up top and deal with a new Barak, because he is looking like he is going to do the Beetle build. Yeah, indeed. So we want to make sure that we stop him from pushing and creating a massive wave. We were able to get our first tribute cap. And like I said, don't ever worry if you don't get the if you fail to get the first tribute cycle. It's not the end of the world. If your team is good enough and you're not that far behind, even if you are far behind on the Cursed Hollow, it's not really that detrimental to lose the first tribute cycle. Like I said, it's not desired, but it's not the end of the world. There's a big old fight happening in the mid right now. See if we can go down and be behind them and clean up. That is the real Nova right there. There is the Ravenous Spirit. I was able to get Nova. I do not have Void Prison up quite yet, unfortunately. I did freeze a new Barak there because I don't want him to get away. There we go. That's all we needed. So we end up getting a complete wipe. It's a 1-for-5. I guess technically 2-for-5. I believe someone else died there. And yeah, taking the boss as soon as possible is definitely going to be ideal here. The Azera is going to be a tank-a-tool. There we go. Nicely done. We're going to get a regen globe out of this as well. So far, so good. Abathur needs to be real careful here. I'm not sure where he's going, but I want to make sure he realizes that he's not behind any sort of cover. There we go. Taking down the turrets is good enough for me, man. I do see the Butcher. I got him back up because I have a feeling that the rest of the team is on their way. There's Lambs of the Slaughter there, actually used by the Butcher right before he died. But look how much damage we're doing thanks to the Giant Killer there on a new Barak. He had no chance. Looks like we were able to get another kill down below somewhere as well. Nova goes down. And just like that, we are rocking and rolling. Team Solo Q Mid Salinas 9 LMQ Copenhagen Wolves Toys R Us. Have your way, Toasty Quiznos, FBI Investigation Station doing work right now. All right, I'm gonna have my Void Prison back up. I need to be cautious whenever I pass the mid here. Just wanted to make sure I grab the regen globe. Or 22 stacks of 13 minutes. I should be at 26, but that's not that big of a deal. I'm gonna go for the boss right now. This is a little bit risky, but I think we have the DPS to do it. Well, unless Falstad runs right into the stun. If we can steal this boss camp, that'd be great. Two Void Prisons, two Zeratuls. Well, isn't this interesting? Oh, what a play by Falstad using the Mighty Gust. Fantastic play by our Falstad player. We've seen that happen before on the funny videos montage, but man, that was a great play. It's finally good to see it happen in the flesh. Beautiful play by our Falstad player. Totally making up for that last Mighty Gust. And we were able to steal not only the boss camp, but get our very first tribute cycle. And this cycle is way more powerful. I was able to save Nazebo there. I actually wasn't trying to save Nazebo so much as to just make sure that we did have a, that we did get the cap. It was a double Void Prison, but going back to what I was talking about earlier, the first tribute cycle didn't net the enemy team anything. Our first tribute cycle ends up netting us not only all the forts, but also a keep, and that is huge, 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 huge. I'm going to be going for Nexus Blades level 20. Level 20 is a very, very, it's an easy pick. Sometimes I try rewind, but again, it all kind of comes around the whole, well, that requires a higher skill cap than what I am able to do. More or less so, yeah, that makes sense. A little bit less than an actual Zeratul player. I mean, I don't play Zeratul that often. I think everyone pretty much knows that. We are firing on all cylinders here, and I am okay with that. I'm definitely going to take this regen globe here. So 24 stacks at 15 minutes. I should be at 30 stacks, but like I said, it's not that big of a deal. Just as long as we're making sure that we're making good engagements, making sure that we're not overextending, and also making sure that we are not getting ourselves killed by the other team's stealthies. Just trying to keep the Butcher honest there. Falstad needs to be real careful. Never mind, that was the Abathur Falstad. That was Abathur Stad. Nice zombie wall by the enemy team's Zeebo player, but we are going to get another turret down. There comes the void prisons all over the place. Instantly take out a new Barak. Instantly take out Zeraful. Instantly take out Nazebro Duncanstan. And that is how you do it right there. Nova even gets killed by our Vala player, which I'm sure was feeling pretty cathartic after getting that kill. And we're just going to go ahead and three keep him. And that should be it. So what a way to turn around after an abysmal couple of games. It feels like retribution, you know? It feels good. I got to be careful here. Now I'm going to be okay. Don't worry about me, Abathur. I'm watching my HP. There you go. So very quick and easy game. Final total 25-15. Again, check the link down below for the build. Try it out. Let me know how you do. And of course, until next time, I will see you all in the next video. Until then, so long, everybody!